an idea of something we could do that could be kind of fun.
Okay.
I know you guys always go to Pops, where a lot of stuff goes down, especially episode one, season, well, last episode of, anyways, yeah. It's a diner, it's fun. I love that you guys actually, I'll tell you later. But you're always like having milkshakes, Jughead's having the hamburgers. Like every kid does, you have a cool diner. I thought we could do a new challenge called the milkshake challenge, where you go to it anywhere that sells milkshakes and you see how fast you can down a full milkshake right. with your buddies.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It's the Riverdale milkshake challenge.
We do it every day.
You want to try it?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Let's go do it right now.
Let's do it.
You good? All right, I'll get in the middle. Komet, wearing this.
Are you wearing this? Are you part of this?
I'm in, man.
Oh my god.
This is
going
to go so quickly.
Oh, I'm sucking it.
Oh my god, we don't
we're
have.
We're sucking it at the same time.
Will you stop? That's it, please. That's going to be a meme. And
do we look straight into camera while doing it?
Do we look directly into camera while we count down?
I have a very big head. Very quick. We'll count down. Ready?
Are
we
ready?
One.
Ready?
Wait. One, two, three.
Complete this search question. Can you milk a blank? Again, family show. Can you milk a blank? Type it in. Whatever you think it is, tell me when you're locked in.
Okay.
Locked and loaded?
Locked and loaded.
Press the red button.
All right, press the red button. Miley, what did you write?
Kitten.
And KJ, what did you write?
Goat.
Goat. Kitten and goat, let's see it. KJ, take a seat.
Everyone knows you can milk a goat.
Come on, man. Can you milk it? That's the question.
It's a little convenient that the house keeps winning.
No, come on. No, we have no idea.
I'm just kind of saying.
Can you milk a cat? I mean, who would ever know? That's great.
All right, no.
I think it's up to you.
I don't know.
Just think of one. Think of one. Think of one.
A dog.
No.
I bet it's on there.
Let's see dog.
Yeah.
Yikes. What is going on?
This isn't fair.
This is weird. Okay.
We're all Southern.
All right.
We milk everything there.
Right.
Milk everything.
Can you milk a...
I mean, I'm just going to go with cow.
Yes, thank you. Yeah. Cow, let's see
thank
cow.
You.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, no.
I appreciate that.
These are people asking the internet.
I know, I did.
They are asking the internet, can you milk this thing?
I'm going to ask about person.
What is a thing that people might think you could milk?
Okay, ew. It's my turn.
Okay, so.
Yeah, it's Brandy's turn.
I'm going to go with llama.
Llama.
That's interesting.
Okay, now, if you don't get this one, it's Riverdale's to steal. Can you milk a llama?
Oh!
That's a second fail. Riverdale.
Cole, what are you thinking?
Okay. What do you guys got?
Okay, it's our turn.
It's team Riverdale.
What are we thinking?
Huddle.
We get to do it again afterwards.
All right.
Oh, you have
the answer?
Yeah.
You guys seem very
confident.
Take it away.
We are.
Cole, go for it.
Pig.
Pig!
Let's see pig!
Not bad.
Oh, yes!
No, pig! Let's see what the answers were.
Yes, by the way. No.
Horse!
I told you!
And man!
Hey! Mom, thank you. God, no.
Hey!
Oh!
Stop it.
Jiminy Christmas!
Let's get to the final round.
All right. Final round. Noah and Cole, you're up.
It's clear the screen.
Noah!
Noah, go! Cole, do it!
We're going down.
Okay, this is the final round. This is for the game. Complete this internet search.
No!
You didn't ask
again. No, not yet. I didn't ask you anything.
And then delete your history.
Why are people afraid of blank? Tell me when you're locked in.
Wait, what? I did it.
Did you do it?
Yeah.
All right, what did you write, Noah?
I wrote dogs.
Why are people afraid of dogs? Cole, what did you
dogs
write?
Sweet.
I wrote me.
Why are people afraid of me?
People are afraid of you. No one's afraid of you.
Watch.
Let's see. Me and dogs.
Yeah, no one's either. No one's afraid
Nobody
of either
answered.
Ones.
Well, that's
Jimmy.
Comforting to me.
Why are people afraid of The Dark?
Oh, that's
ooh, The
that's
Dark.
Mine.
Let's see, Dark.
Are you speaking from experience?
The Dark! All right, Team Cyrus is going
there. Here we go, here we go.
Now you go back right, over there. All right.
Another one?
Miley. It's up to you. Why are people afraid of?
Clowns.
Ooh.
Yes, of course.
That's a good one.
It.
The movie
yeah,
it. Very it. Topical, very topical. Let's see, clowns. Okay, Noah, round two.
Again?
You can.
Oh, okay.
Things you're afraid of.
Oh.
What are people afraid of?
Oh, heights.
Heights.
Oh, that's a good one.
Heights, let's see, heights.
Yeah.
Ooh. First fail. Tish, what do you think?
I forgot what you told me. Oh, I know.
One more fail. What do you think?
Why are people afraid of?
Ghosts.
Yes.
Wow, that was a good one.
Let's see, ghosts.
Damn.
Oh! Over to Riverdale to steal. They could win this entire game.
If they don't win this, then we win the whole thing, correct?
No, if they win this, they win the whole thing.
That's right. But if they lose this, then we win.
Then you win the whole thing.
That's what I'm talking about.
They get one guess. You guys get one guess to win this entire game.
Really?
Yeah.
Insects.
This is it, for the win or the lose.
Spiders.
That's a very good answer. Spiders, let's see, spiders!
The Cats of Riverdale.
This is why I'm very, very impressed. First of all, your voice, your accent. where are you from? It's not Australia.
I'm from New Zealand. Not Australia, I'm from New Zealand.
Yeah, New Zealand.
Yeah. Not Australia.
Yeah. And you're not even a real redhead, are you?
No. I'm not American. I'm not a real redhead.
Sorry.
None of it really fits, but.
So when you auditioned to play Archie, were you like, there's no way I'm going to get this?
Absolutely.
Right?
Yeah, and I was even more terrified about what I would look like with red hair.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What color is it?
Because it's either going to go two ways.
Why?
You're either going to suit it.
Why is that?
Huh? Why is that?
Well, if you're not ginger. Yeah. Like, you're either going to suit it or you're not going to suit it at all.
That's true.
But
yeah.
It kind of, I think, worked. And
I think it's
we prefer
think
him this
we
way.
We honestly prefer him
it's weird
with his red hair.
What color is your hair?
Black, dark black.
It's like exactly like your color.
Well, I mean, this is one of the finest toupees on Amazon. Thank you for saying that. I appreciate it. I really appreciate that. I want to hear, like, how. Because this is what Jughead looks like, right? So you get the cartoon, that's Jughead, right? So I go, how are they going to make this work? Are they going to keep the crown? Were you concerned at all? Like,
they just made me turn profile, and they measured the size of my nose.
No, but
they were like, okay.
No, but Cole, did you know that they were going to keep the crown, or how are they going to play that off?
We didn't know. I guess I had asked pretty early on, and they didn't really have a solid idea, but I actually have the crown here. I brought it for you.
You brought it? Because, I mean, this they made it work. This is the crown in the show.
Yeah. It's more like a beanie.
Yeah.
It's a beanie.
It's fantastic.
What is it gonna
whoop? You brought it here?
Could you put it on? It's all right.
I mean, sure, I'd be...
There's a way to do it.
Don't
really?
Smell
it's the real one?
Don't smell it.
Don't smell it.
I'm not going to smell it.
There's only one of those beanies.
There's only one? For real?
Yeah.
Is this the right side like this?
Yeah.
Just like that. That's it.
You
got it.
Got it. Don't even calm down. Now look in the camera and say, I'm weird. I'm a weirdo.
In our town? Yeah. Wow. I'm honored to do this. This is really fun. Everyone knows you from the show, loves you. I got to, Thanks. But another guy that we really loved was Luke Perry. Mm. And I kind of grew up on Luke Perry, and I was just kind of shocked by the news that he's not with us anymore. And I couldn't really even kind of wrap my head around it. I can't even imagine how you felt.
It was everyone was pretty shocked, and I think. It's not every day you come across a guy like Luke. Like, Luke is the kind of person who did everything he can to make whoever you are, no matter how big or small you are, feel comfortable and feel welcome. And I think there's not really, it's hard to kind of put into words how that makes me feel, but yeah.
I mean, he was your dad. I mean,
yeah, we had a really close relationship. he would call my parents every week and like keep them updated on how I'm going. Like if I had a cold or something, he'd be like, I got him. I took some Gatorade to his apartment the other day. Like he's
is that right? Got,
yeah, him and my dad were always texting each other and stuff. And he made an effort. He made such a huge effort from the very beginning. And to me, I was like, I don't know. Like I wish I could be like that. You know?
Well, you can. You can be like that.
I can. I can.
You are like that.
You haven't really talked about it, except on Instagram I follow you, and you posted a photo of it, and it's...
You follow me on Instagram?
Yeah. I have to. Come on, man. We're boys.
We are, yeah.
I gotta take care of you, man. I don't know if I'll bring Gatorade to your apartment, but I mean, I just... But you put a picture of Luke, and you put, rest in love, bro.
And that's my favorite photo of Luke.
That's a great photo. Why'd you choose that photo of Luke?
I just think he's just in complete and utter peace in that photo. You know what I mean? Like, look at him.
He's just living his life. Right
living
there,
the dream.
Living the dream. Yeah. It was very beautiful that you did that, buddy. You brought something because we were talking last time, and you said like you were writing things down when you or your friends got drunk. You would write things down on your phone just so you can remember that you said it.
Yeah. For some reason, I felt like, you know, when I first moved to LA and I was drinking for the first time and getting drunk, and that was like a whole new experience for me. And I thought that I was like being so philosophical or so saying all these revolutionary things that I needed to remember.
No, Lily, no.
I know.
You'll when you get older, you'll realize.
The next day I'm reading the list and I'm like, what the?
Well, you brought a couple just so I could read it right now.
To give you an idea of what goes through my head when I'm not sober.
Here we go. This one says, it's never a skeleton dance, it's a skeleton jig.
That is something I said. I think I was watching probably a Tim Burton movie and there were skeletons dancing and I was like, you know what? They're never dancing, it's a jig. It's called a skeleton jig. And this is something that I thought was...
This is really fun. Oh, this one's a good one. You can't be taught to be a legend.
Right.
You can't be. Let me tell you. Were you talking in the
got to be a legend.
Were you talking in the mirror? Were you saying in the mirror?
No, I don't remember.
It might be one of your friends saying that, but that's
no.
A great
I
one.
I said that.
Oh, you said it.
I don't.
You can't be taught to be a legend.
Probably referring to myself. Yeah.
So I'm sorry.
Good
You're
advice.
Cut off. Yeah.
Very good advice.
And this last one was pretty good. I like it because.
Thank you.
If you have a pet goat and you didn't name it Billy, who the hell are you? You're the great. You got to put a book out. You've been coming on the Tonight Show for almost 20 years. Do you believe that?
I do.
Yeah.
I lived it. Yeah.
Yeah. You were. That was you. Well, this is you and your brother, Dylan Sprouse, on the Tonight Show with Jay Leno. And.
I can't even tell which one is me.
That's you. That's you right there. Yeah. Uh-huh. Look at this little guy. Uh-huh. What do you remember about that? Anything?
Nothing.
No, nothing.
No, I remember my brother, and you can see by his posture, he was talking the whole time, and I was actually sitting the same way I am right now.
You
now
really
that,
are sitting
now
just
that
like
I
that.
I realize it.
That's how you sit. Yeah, right. Amazing. But you look, Jay's holding a picture. You drew a picture of Jay Leno.
Yes.
And gave it to Jay, which we had a zoom in of that, which is kind of, it's just interesting. It's just, I mean, you were young. You were young and,
Well, in keeping with tradition, I actually drew you one tonight as well.
You drew a picture of me?
I did. I wanted to make sure that we kept this in line and.
Oh, this is.
I mean, it's been a little while, so.
Yeah, it's been almost 20 years later. I'd love to see it.
A little bit better.
Thank you, buddy. Thank you. There it is right there. Fantastic. Wow. Not bad. I mean, you've gotten better. I can definitely see the improvement. It's just amazing.
You don't like it?
I will cherish this. Are you kidding me? I'm going to hang this on my fridge.
Do you like it?
I'm gonna hang it on my fridge.
Thanks.
I love that, pal. Thank you for doing that. I heard that you were recently getting into vinyl records.
Yeah, and I heard that you love vinyl too, bro.
I'm a big vinyl. I do. I love vinyl records.
I love it, bro. I love it. Last year, a really good friend of mine, Dimey, who's one of the lighting guys on Riverdale, invited me to his house, and we've been listening to records. Like, he's introduced me to so much new music, and it like really forced me to listen to albums from start to finish.
Yeah.
And
hey, what do you like about putting it, like physically putting it on, or
I love it. I love smelling them. I love, you know, like this. I love the smell of old stuff.
I like the smell of books.
Yeah, like old books. As a kid, I used to like dig things up, and then the next week later, I would dig it back out of the dirt, and then, you know, pretend that I'm discovering it for the first time. And be like,
oh yeah, you're like Indiana Jones. Yeah. That's a genius
but
thing for kids.
Kind of has that effect on me.
Yeah,
I love it.
I love looking at that. I mean, Quest is a big. He has one of the biggest collections I've ever even heard of.
Legend.
What are you up to now, Quest? What number around?
Probably 170.
170,000.
No.
Yeah. 170,000. It's a building. He has a building of records.
Have you listened to all of them?
Not even 10%.
Yeah. What album would you recommend I get if I don't? Maybe I have it already, but.
Okay. Do you know Boney M?
No. Boney M?
Yeah. No. Boney M. Night Flight to Venus. Is one of my, it'll trip you out for sure.
Yep. I don't mind a little trip, but Boney M, Night Flight
to Venus. I would recommend, you know, maybe a glass of wine and to listen to it at nighttime.
Really?
Yeah. It feels like you're about to get onto a spaceship and fly to space.
you do the do. You're in Mountain
I
Dew.
I do the do. Well, my mom drank it when I was in the womb. It's her fault.
No way.
Yes.
I thought it'd be kind of fun if you and I, maybe there's a few different Mountain Dew inspired products.
Mm-hmm.
These are real. We're not paid for by Mountain Dew, but I thought we'd give it a try and see what you think, okay?
Yeah, let's try some Mountain Dew products.
All right, this first
products.
One, here you go. This is for you. This is a lip balm.
Ooh.
This is Mountain Dew lip balm. I don't know.
Oh, it's darker than you would expect.
It is. Mountain Dew is not this darker green.
A little bit of a scent, like a lime.
Yeah, a little bit of a lime, okay.
I don't want to mess up my...
Oh, yeah, your lipstick, yeah. Me neither. No, I'm the same.
All right. I mean, moisturizing.
Not bad.
Yeah, that is okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I like this. Not bad.
Yeah.
I give this a...
It's like a 6 out of 10.
6 out of 10, sure. Yeah. I'll give it a 7.
Okay.
All right, that's good. All right, ready for this one?
Yeah, yeah. Ooh,
right, this one's very interesting.
This is scary.
It's Mountain Dew inspired ice cream called Mountain Moo. It's made by Mooville Creamery in Michigan. We got it sent to us just for you.
Oh,
Mountain Moo.
So kind.
Here we go. Oh, so
okay.
You need a spoon.
Oh, thank you. This is a nice.
You're like, how do I eat it? Yeah, okay, here we go. All right, it's the right color.
I would not go out of my way to eat this.
It's kind of interesting. I don't know where. It doesn't quite make the right turn, does it?
Tastes like the flavor of the milk after you have Fruit Loops, like the milk afterwards.
Now I'm jumping back in.
Like, first, take another. Don't you kind of think?
I kind of like that. Now I like it more.
If you think of it going in.
Yeah, it's like Fruit Loops milk.
Yeah, I would not eat that again, no.
I would totally do it. You totally sold me on it now and changed
okay.
it. Yeah. This next one is an alcohol-related product.
Okay.
Here we go. Let's pretend we're at Coachella.
Oh.
Here we go.
This would be a dream.
This is a distillery. It's a Mountain Dew inspired vodka called by Three Olives in Jersey City.
Okay.
Okay. This flavor is called. Ready for this? Dude.
Dude.
Yeah. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers, dude.
It's actually not as
bad. No, it's not as bad. No,
as
yeah,
I thought
yeah
it
that's not bad. But this one, right? I would do dude. But this one, the next one, this last one here, this is a real. I have not tried this. I thought maybe we could try this together. This is real. This is Mountain Dew Flamin' Hot. Have you ever tried this?
I'm such an original Dew girl that I don't
the orange
partake in Code Red or anything like that.
Oh.
So this is scary.
It smells good. Ooh. It's good. No.
Ooh, it's got a little burn. Spicy.
It's got a burn aftertaste to it.
Yeah, it's a little bit of burn in me.
Sorry, you want more dude?
No, I'm okay.
All right, maybe.
It'll take a little bit more.
Take a dude.
Wash it down.
Yeah, wash it down. There you go. Thank you for trying that stuff with me, pal.
Ooh, that's not good.
Now look, here we go.
It's worse the second time.